What I'm going to do next is to clip a St. Croix Advantage front and a St. Croix Advantage hind. I'm going to clip the front with a hammer and I'm going to clip the hind with a bob punch. St. Croix Advantage shoe is a full rim shoe except at the heels, where it has a flatter area to give more heel support. So it's got an outer rim to give breakover, an inner concave edge to help with traction and the cleaning of the dirt out of the hoof. When I'm clipping with a hammer, I try to get my shoulder in line with the anvil. I put the shoe over the edge, about 1/8 of an inch, and hold it up, not quite at 45 degrees. And then I hit with the ball of the hammer into the corner of the anvil. And when you're clipping, look at what you're hitting. I've got my shoulder in line with the anvil. I put the shoe about just over 1/8 of an inch over the edge of the anvil, lift it up, and I hit directly into the edge, right at the center of the toe. We go about halfway through. At this point, we've got a lump at the back edge of the, onto the bearing surface. That's going to be drawn into the clip. So what we do now, we put the clip over the edge, hold it out a little bit, and just flatten the bubble. Don't try and draw the clip yet, just flatten the bubble. Once you've got the base of the clip now, once we have the base of the clip to the size that we want, now we can come up with the corner of the hammer up the middle of the clip to draw it up to a point. Forge it smooth. Turn the clip towards you, level behind the clip. Put the clip over the horn, forge the clip into the edge of the shoe, and then just set the clip to the angle of the hoof wall. So what I'm looking for now for this Advantage shoe is a nail that will fit well into the crease and into the nail hole and lock tight, but still have a slim blade for the fine-footed horses. So what I'm going to choose is a Capewell Slim Blade 5. And it locks down well into the crease, drive tight, and it's got a thin blade. With the Hind St. Croix Advantage shoe, what we're going to do, we're going to clip with a different method. We're going to use a bob punch. So the bob punch will fit down into the full ring, and as we drive the bob punch in, we're going to aim it for the outer corner. That will displace the metal to the outside. Once we've done that, then we need to bend the material back and then draw a clip out of it. So when we're using the bob punch, it's an extra step than when we use a hammer. Take our bob punch, we aim for the outside corner. What we've done now, we've created a bubble on the outside. That's the first step. The second step is to set the bob punch, just like we would get it to the same stage as a hammer clip. So now we take that bubble and we just hit down onto it. We'll stop. And what you can see there, when you look at the back of the clip, now you can see it's about the same shape as it would be as if you'd hammer clipped it. So when I look at these two clips, the hammer clip and the bob punch clip, in the hammer clip, we have a source material and the clip started all in one from one position. With the bob punch, we've had to bob punch it and we've had to set the clip to get to the same point. And we have to take the bob punch clip to this point before we draw it. Many times people skip this point and try and draw the clip and end up with a very thin clip. This is a bob punch clip. So now once we've set the base material, we can take our clip out up to a point using the corner of the hammer. I'm using the back corner of the hammer and I'm going right up the middle of the material. I'll level behind the clip. Make sure it's level. Then I'll set the clip to the angle of the hoof wall. Put the bob punch in. Aim it to the outside corner. create the material. Now we have to set that material to the, as the base of the clip. Once we've got the material set, then we can go on and draw a clip. Level the back of the clip. Forge it into the edge of the shoe. Set the clip to the angle of the hoof wall. I'm going to do two more modifications to this shoe now. I'm going to blunt the toe just to move the breakover back a little bit more, even though it's got a rolled edge, and I'm going to extend the heels. I'm going to blunt the toe over the horn, so I'm going to put it just in front of the nail hole so I don't damage the nail hole, and I'll push it across, slightly flattening the toe. I'll do half of it, I'll turn it, I'll put it just in front of the nail hole, and I'll push it across. And that movement there will just cause the toe to go blunt. If I put it on the horn, I've got my tongs in the same direction as the toe. I just push it over a little, just in front of the nail hole. I turn it, I repeat the same thing. It's not how hard you hit it right now, it's hitting it gently and getting it to move. We're getting a little bit more symmetrical. There we go. Now we've got a blunt toe on this shoe. So now we can see we've blunted the toe, slightly squared it away from the original round shape. This way we can set it back half the thickness of the hoof wall, but it's still giving support to the hoof wall, where a full square toe will be fitted back onto the white line. Next step now is to extend both heels to give a bit of posterior support. We've got enough material to do it. Because we've set the shoe back at the toe, we can extend the heels. While I brush my shoe, I'll hold it basically in line with the heel. I'll lift it up. I'll take the round of my hammer, and about half inch in front of the end of the heel, I'll hit with the round of my hammer, lifting up. If we want to turn it out a little bit more, we can just put it over the edge of the anvil. But I don't want it turned out to the side much on this one. I just want it going straight back. It's an extension, not a trailer. I hold the tongs in line with the heel. I put it, lift it up, the heel of the anvil, and I hit about a half inch in front of the end of the heel with the round of my hammer. I'm lifting my tongs as I'm forging. It's turning that heel out. So it's basically facing straight back as an extension. If I want to turn it out just a little bit more, I can put it onto the face of the anvil and just tap it out how much I like. But those are heel those are extensions, not trailers. Trailers would stick out laterally. I'm selecting a nail for the St. Croix Advantage number one. What I'm looking for is a nail that will lock well into the V crease and the nail hole, and a nail that's got a fairly thin shank, so it's not going to create much wall displacement. What I used when I lived in the States was a Capewell 5 slim bled nail, and I found this a very versatile nail that I can use in a lot of different types of horses. So what we've got is a simple modification, blunt toe, extended heels, some side clips made with a bob punch.